Connecting. Am I in? For the life of me, I can't work out why I've gone red. Why I look so red. Oh, well, now I can hear myself. Shut up, your bell end. Shit, that's really loud. Ignore this guy, he's a dickhead. Hello, two viewers. Two waiting. Scheduled for the 19th. That's now. Anybody? I've got one watching. Somebody will get really bored of this really quickly and just go, oh, sod this guy. He's red and he's playing a game. One watching. That's probably me. So I've decided, other than the fact I'm rather red, and I can't work out why. Let's bring the lighting down a wee bit. Well, it adds to the horror element of the game, I suppose, but it's slightly frustrating. Ever since I took this camera and filmed stuff with it on a shoot, it just doesn't behave the way it used to, which is really, really frustrating. So, and I've looked at it and I've gone into the settings. 120 FPS is off, which is because the streaming software is streaming at 60 frames per second. No point streaming at 120. Stop. Or white balance. I just need to go. Oh, what do I look like now? It's all right. It's not that bad. It's not that bad, is it? It's a little bit pinky. I'm just gonna blast myself out with a bit of light. There we go. I'm less red now. According to my screen, I look very red. Oh, I know what it might be. Camera's picking up the red Major Dolby's cat thing. Maybe it's that. But I always have that on. Because it's not in the shot, let's remove it. Let's see what that looks like. No, it's made hardly any different. Oh, it's got a little bit different. Okay, we'll leave it like that. Three watching. Hello, three. Before I stick this on, if you're new to the channel, which you might be, because I seem to have got over 400 new subscribers in the last week. It's all to do with Princess Diana, so thank you, Princess Diana. They really liked my verve. I should really explain something. That was on Twitter. I'd seen that piece of footage before, because I'm a little bit... that's the only part of me that's still royalist, is the Lady Diana, Princess Diana, Diana Spencer. Big Lady Diana fan, and have been since I was very young. And what was interesting was I'd seen that. There's not anything I haven't seen on Princess Diana over the years. Documentaries, news clippings, interviews, you name it. It's all there, but I just happened to catch this video on Twitter, and it was a 25 or 26 minute video that was edited really, really naffly as well. Like, they zoomed in, they cropped in. I'd seen the footage many of times. I always found it quite funny, because it's basically Diana when she just recently got divorced. She was with old Dodie, and she was coming out of the gym. And she would really piss off the photographers, who'd be always waiting there for her, because it was right around that time where she had just got, like, divorced. So she was, there was never a time when she wasn't in the news, but this was particularly aggressive. And they used to sort of, like, wait outside. Used to be a chemist's on the corner of, I think it was in Sydney, Kensington, I think, the gym. And they used to wait by the chemist. There would be like 20, 30 photographers. And she got so annoyed with it that over a two-week period, she wore the same clothes. That way she... that way that they couldn't have an exclusive, because is this from Tuesday or is this from Wednesday? Is this from Thursday? They just didn't know. So basically they just... she ruined their shots by wearing the same clothes every day coming out of the gym. So anyway, to cut a long story short... I'd seen this footage, which badly cropped, badly edited, with why they chose Tears for Fears, Everybody Wants to Rule the World. I have no idea, but that was going around on Twitter. And I think there was something like 100,000 views of that at the time. And I was thinking, they could have used a better piece of music than that. I mean, at least get it appropriate, period appropriate. And also, you know, it adds to the authenticity of the piece. It is 1997, and I did go into the charts in 1997 to see what was in the charts in 1997 at that particular time that Diana came out of the gym. And it was The Verve. And I thought, bloody hell, that's an appropriate song. Especially as, you know, I mean, the fact that she's walking along the street, you know. So anyway, I just basically replaced the music. Didn't crop in on the ITN footage, which I took from an ITN YouTube channel. And it's got something like 80,000 views now. And something like 450 new or 500 subscribers have joined my channel just because they loved that. So that's kind of cool. So to answer the question, if you're new to the channel, if I don't know how many people are watching, I upload archive television, archive film, and every so often I do an edit because that's what I do for a living. I am a videographer, part-time delivery driver, videographer, cameraman, that occasionally does a live stream. They're few and far between at the moment because it's just hectic. I live on a boat and I'm having loads and loads and loads and loads and loads of work done on this boat, and you don't have the much room at the best of times, let alone when you're moving from one thing to another place, fixing that place, then moving it back to that. It's just a constant moving things about. So my streams on Saturdays are non-existent right now, and they probably will be until I actually get the boat done, which will be at the beginning of July. But every so often I will jump in for a live stream, and this is why I'm here tonight, because I am about to play an old game, 2 years old now, The Quarry. I've had it for 2 years. I bought it in a Steam sale, like everyone always does when they're on Steam. They sort of overspend, shed loads of money, and then it sits in your Steam game section for years before you even play it. So I thought, well, sod it, I'm going to play it today. It's called The Quarry, made by Supermassive Games. I think Supermassive Games? Should have double-checked that. Played a few of their games in the past, Man of Medan, very story-based narratives. There's one in the desert with soldiers, which I quite liked. They're always... They annoy me sometimes, these games. Even though I enjoy the narrative game and I enjoy the cinematics of it, sometimes they annoy the shit out of me because the characters are just so annoying. The voice acting is annoying. The characters are annoying. The heavy-handedness of 80s homages is like Stranger Things times 100. It's just, they may as well just walk around with 3D glasses on their faces. And just talk constantly about Back to the Future. It's very heavy-handed. Normally it's very heavy-handed. I've not played The Quarry. I've not even put it on yet. So I'm about to delve into an 80s horror. So thanks for watching, whoever is in here. Say hello in the chat. Don't be strangers. Don't be strangers. I have a chai tea. So here we go. As I said, I put it on just to make sure it loaded in all right and everything, but I haven't played it. So I haven't seen any footage on it, any YouTube videos. I tend to avoid spoilers. So I don't know how far we'll get while I'm streaming this, but let me move that up there because that looks like it could be in the way of it. Right. Here we go then. Let me make sure, because I tell you now, the chat on my screen. There we go. Right. single player. I'm a single player. Oh, hold on a minute. That says continue. I want new game. To continue is literally just the first 25 seconds of driving through a forest. So let's go with the start. New game. You sure you want to overwrite this game? Yes, because it was nothing. It wasn't a game. Okay, so here we go. David Arquette, everybody. These games tend to have, like, they're getting more and more. Evergore. Getting more and more, kind of. Huge, well, not huge, but established character actors. Including Lance Henriksen. And 5 points to anyone who could name Lance Henriksen in Ted Raimi as well. You name Lance Henriksen film. Probably not going to be that much talking, don't know who you are. But it's already got Lance Henriksen in it. And Ted Raimi. So I probably won't be much talking for a bit. I remember him. Big guy. American History X. Then he lost loads of weight. My Name is Earl. I remember that series. I know some of these names. Grace Zabriskie. Laura's mum in Twin Peaks. That's a good sign. Route 919. Laura, and the fact she's called Laura as well. God, I love Grace. She's a fantastic actress.
Why'd you kill the music?
I think you know why.
Oh, audio. What's going on with the audio? Hold on a second. This is where I have to go into the... No?
I don't think I do.
Begins with an L? Like the L word?
No.
Lesbians?
Lesbians. Hold on a second. I've got an issue
lost,
with the audio.
Max, we're
no.
Lost.
Just... Oh. This always just, happens. We're in... The technical... I just want to
geographic
go to
flux.
Right,
start,
so... Lost.
Start menu.
That's the...
Okay, settings. Audio. Have I got to go into the actual... I have to go into my settings. Yes, I can hear an echo. So I expect you can hear an echo as well. So, what are we doing here? Audio, game capture. There's two audio sources coming in. Hello? Hello? There we go. There's one. Can see that one. Game capture. Okay, that should advanced audio properties. Monitor off. Output. No. Monitor off. Okay. Right. Let's see whether this makes a difference.
Baitable.
Makes a difference for me. Does it make a difference for you?
Oh, heads up.
Oh, we're missing this. Oh, I'm gonna have to start this again. Unbelievable. Oh, I should have checked that before I started. I apologize for that technical issue, but the last thing you want to hear is an echo. New game. Continue. Prologue. Yes. Got to overwrite it. Sorry about that. We'll have to. We'll try that again. Ignore that first 5 minutes. Let me see whether the audio is coming out as loud as you can hear it. The sun is Testing, 1, 2, 3. Because I've got nobody in here, but I've got two people watching. It's funny, isn't it? You have 7,800 subscribers, and one of those people that are watching is me right now. Go figure. Live streaming on YouTube. Ted Raimi, everybody. Sometimes I do feel a little bit like, if I was being really honest, sometimes I do feel like not everyone, but a lot of my subscribers are selfish. They just come and get the free content and then they fuck off. Which is fine. I mean, I'm not making any money out of it. I mean, I actually invest my own money in getting some of this stuff. It'd just be nice that if just 20% or 10% or 5% of my subscribers maybe catch a stream, a live stream, maybe not a gaming stream, because let's face it, it's a stream killer on this channel, because the average age of most people that watch my channel are 65 plus. Don't think this would really appeal to them. I'm not expecting miracles, but you know, when I was doing streaming for 6 months dedicated every Saturday night, so hard to get people in from this channel. We're talking about like programs and TV movies from the 60s and 70s. It's like you'd think that they would come in, but no, they stay away from the live streams. Contaminating. Right, so let's turn that up. Make sure that's I have to hear. Don't think this would really appeal to them. I'm not expecting miracles, but
can hear that.
You know, when I was doing streaming for 6 months, dedicated every Saturday night.
That's me. That's just me talking out of bollocks right there. Right. Here we go then. Here we go.
Why'd you kill the music?
I think you know why.
I don't think I do.
Begins with an L? Like the L word?
Lesbians?
Lost, Max. We're lost.
We're in geographic flux.
Right, so lost.
That's debatable.
Oh, heads up.
Nice catch there, hon.
Gotta
look
I'm
for the
not
action, the one who hit the pothole.
Well, maybe the pothole hit us. Ever think about that?
Wow, that is like Olympic level goalpost moving.
Thank you.
Very impressive.
Thank you.
Why do I recognize that guy?
Yeah, still totally lost.
I've seen him before.
You know what, Max? It's okay. It doesn't make you any less of a man.
You know, if Columbus hadn't gotten lost and landed on these golden shores, there would be no United States of America. Goodbye, hot dogs. See you later, apple pie.
Columbus never actually landed in North America.
What are you talking about?
Didn't even know he wasn't in Asia.
Are you serious?
Just another guy who didn't want to admit he was lost.
Well, just another guy who's got a whole day named after him.
From the movie,
so
thinking, what?
Put that in your pipe and smoke it.
I thought he discovered
America. Just get us to camp already before I roll my eyes out of my head, please.
I'm working on it.
I thought he landed at Plymouth Rock, but that was somebody else. I was being silly. Pick leaflet, pick map. Pick map.
Voila.
Logical thing to do,
what
I think.
What is that?
Yeah.
No, but seriously, what happened to the normal map?
This is the normal map.
The one on the phone.
No bars.
Where do I know him from?
Okay, let's see. So we are... Well, I guess they don't put summer camps on maps. Have you seen any signs for it?
It's a teen thing. It's a teen
Hey, problem. Eyes on the road!
Santa Clarita's diet. I remember that. Oh shit. I remember that. Just as I remember that, I come off the road. Santa Clarita Diet. The Drew Barrymore.
Stop the car!
That's where I've seen him. Well, so far, those two commands are pretty easy.
Should have kept your eyes on the road, mate. God. Jeez. Got a pretty young lady there. Make sure you look after her.
Yeah. I mean, still in one piece.
Jesus Christ, what do you think that was? A bear?
What? No, Max, it wasn't a bear.
What was it?
wasn't a bear.
I think it was a person.
Laura, are you serious? Do you think we hit a person?
I don't know. I mean, it was really close, like really close, but maybe we didn't.
Let me just turn it up a wee bit. There we go. Is that a little bit better? I think that'll be a little bit better.
What is it?
Sounds a bit better.
I really effed this car up.
That's a bit better.
Well, maybe it looks worse than it is.
I should check out the damage before we try to start it up again, huh? Could you grab my, the toolbox from the trunk?
Yeah, okay.
It's the sound of a swamp outside your car. It's one of those where I can't go like free roam. Oh, I can go over there. Oh, he asked me to get her stuff out of the trunk. Get the trunk. Snoop. Yes, Snoop. Kind of, you got to snoop when you get given a chance, haven't you? No, you haven't. That's wrong. Rejected. Max Brinley. Landis University. No reference there at all to John Landis, I'm sure. Oh, did he eat? I think he may have told a fib. He's in university.
Do you need a hand?
Yeah, actually, if you could just shine a light right here.
There you go.
Perfect, thank you.
The sooner we get out of here, the better.
Just picture yourself curling up in front of a big old fire pit singing campfire sing-alongs.
I don't think people curl up right in front of big old fire pits.
Why not?
They don't want to catch
I've seen
fire.
Her before as well.
Picture yourself curling up in front of a big old space heater.
It's the Watcher Cam.
Well, anywhere's better than here.
Somebody is watching you. I can move any mountain. Where am I going? What am I doing? I should stop talking. Oh, there you go. Oh, thank you. I've already seen that. So that's a problem with this game company, is they show text. Okay. Thank you for your interest in Landis University. This year, we were delighted to have received an influx of interesting and excellent applications, only some of which were able to accept. We reviewed your application very carefully, and though we noted several strong features, there is rigorous competition for entry into our graduate programs, and your application was not among those that we were able to accept. We encourage you to apply to other graduate schools, and we wish you every success with your studies. Next page. And beyond. Yours truly, Helena Mason, PhD, graduate of... What a shit. I remember when I went to uni, I don't think I was rejected. I don't think I got rejected from any university. I think the there was only really one university I wanted to go to, and I got in. It was Falmouth. Falmouth University. What am I doing? Dude, what am I doing? If I could remember what he asked me to do instead of waffling... No, let's not look at that again, because that shouldn't come up again. But it does. What am I gonna do? Oh, here you go. Ooh, somebody's in the woods with you. Whenever I play one of these games,
where are you going?
Supermassive
Start
games.
Here.
Just.
I think it's Supermassive.
Stay there for a second, okay? I'm almost done.
Defiant. Are you my boss? Compliant. Hurry up. Oh, let's go with compliant. Don't want to
Max, hurry up!
So I'll tell him to hurry up instead.
I'm worried that there's somebody down there.
Are you serious?
Yeah, they could be hurt. I don't know.
I didn't think we actually hit anything.
Well, I don't know. I heard something, okay? Like a woman.
Do you think we hit her?
No, you swerved.
I just want to check it out.
Okay. All right. Just don't go too far, okay? Be careful.
Yeah.
It's these games sometimes, it's just like, it's so predictive. It's just so pretty. She's going to see something. She's going to come running back. She's going to be freaked out and scared.
Okay. Luck with the car.
It's like what I kind of give up on modern day Hollywood horror and stuff. It's so formulaic now. It's got to that point where, you know, that whole thing where the postmodernism of Scream, where they took the mickey out of those people that would say, be right back, or I'm just going out for a walk, or, you know, because you knew straight away that they weren't coming back. Oh, hello. The Fool. Press left button to view. The Fool. I wonder who this is. We all know a fool when we see one, don't we? Innocence and freedom. Or recklessness and risk-taking. Spontaneity, actions without thought but consequences to match. Think, and don't get burnt. Don't play the fool. Anyway, they all become... What's that? Something there as well. What's that? Harem. Even the music. The music's pretty cool. It's that build-up. It was slightly Carpenter-esque. I didn't read that. Show text. Harum Scarum. Boom, boom. The electronic bit in the background is John Carpenter. I'm not sure what the twang of the guitar would be, but buy tickets now. Slideshow. Fortunes and Freaks. Mystery and Magic. Escapologists and Enigmas. So it's Harum Scarum. Interesting. What's that? There's nothing. Rocks. It's the rocks, isn't it? What's down here? There's got to be something down here, isn't there? Something I'm missing. Gameplay's nice. It's on Epic, or whatever it is, the highest settings. It looks very much like a film. Anything down here? Nothing? She's supposed to be looking for somebody that she thinks they may have hit. Because they didn't hit. The reason why they're here in the first place is because they swerved to avoid hitting something in the road. Well, that's that. What's that again? If I just walked around the whole... Eh? Am I missing something? I think I got to go this way. It's a little bit Resident Evil. It's a bit... I'm going to get lost in a minute. Oh, hello. Hello. What's this? What we got here? What's on the ground? Handcuffs? Escapology. A trunk filled with strange devices. That of an escapologist, perhaps. Good deduction, Sherlock. A relic of a travelling show that must have passed through the area. So we've got a crazy freak show. It's like a Todd Browning's Freaks in the Woods. It was always that X-Files episode where they homage Todd Browning Freaks. With the travelling fair and the twin that was murdering the Siamese twin, if I remember right. Little bit of inspiration there from the 1980. Oh, hello. What's going on here? I went into a cutscene. from the 1980. Is it a 1980 basket case? Belial.
Silas.
Silas. Hello. 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 That was a little bit freaky. Didn't expect that. Torch looks great. Look at that. Who's Silas? The ghostly spirit was calling Silas.
Silas.
Sound design's good. Give you credit. Sound design's good. Camera angle. Oh, cutscene. Something's gonna happen. And that's again formulaic. And it goes into a cutscene. Oh, subliminal. We're going down the old subliminal route. It's good. It's better than the jump scares. I'm sure this game will have plenty of jump scares.
Where are you?
Silas.
Oh, shit.
Silas!
Oh, this has got to have some actions. Oh yes, here we go. Duck. Dragon's Lair. The one remembers Dragon's Lair. These get really tough later on.
What's wrong? Is everything alright?
Holy shit.
Talk to me. What's going on? What's going on?
That's where I lose people.
There was noises all around me.
Honey, take a breath. It's okay. It's the woods. There's a lot of stuff out there. There's animals. It's easy to freak yourself out.
No. Can we just leave, please?
Yeah. Let's go.
Okay.
You alright?
Yes, there we go. Purring like a kid.
Max, come on!
Here we go. We're getting out of here.
Take your girlfriend out of here! Oh, look at that. Would you know it?
Max!
Damn it.
Give me a minute. We've got to go, man.
Laura, you're not helping right now.
Can you just... I am trying to get Silas. Us out of here.
All right, enough!
Shit, I'm sorry, honey. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Just call her honey.
We're okay. We're safe in the car, really. We're gonna be okay.
Ooh.
Jesus!
Oh!
That's Ted Raimi.
Oh my god, my heart just exploded.
I would do that if he turned up at my car.
Roll it down.
Hi, officer.
He's got such an odd face. They've de-aged him.
Are either of you injured?
Really, we're fine. We're just a little shaken up.
Sam Raimi's brother. Mm. Kind of for a while, Sam Raimi used to put Ted Raimi in everything.
Well, you folks want to tell me what happened here?
It's a police officer. Path chosen. Left button to view.
Yo.
What's that?
Hackett's quarry is full of twists and turns, unknown paths and unexplored wonders.
It's quite cool.
With each step taken, you tread a path of your own, matched with its very own consequences. There will be moments throughout your stay that show you that the choices you've made, the path you've chosen, could have gone another way. At Hackett's Quarry, there's no such thing as the wrong way. But be warned.
Oh, there isn't. I don't care about the wrong way or the right
way. Some paths are more dangerous than others.
Yeah, well, that's just the tutorial. if you know these games, basically they give you, you know, each decision that you make is supposed to have a different outcome. But most of the time I find it bullshit. Most of the time I sense bullshit a bit. And I think it's always going to end that way. Or it's... Or it gives you, like, limited possibilities to go your own way. It makes you think that you're going your own way, but really it's still programmed to be a little bit... anyway. Evasive? We swerved off. Honest. I'm going to go with evasive. I don't like Ted Raimi. I don't trust him. Never trusted Ted Raimi.
We're just driving, and it's really, really dark out here, and, I don't know, we must have hit, like, a pothole or something, because we swerved, and now here we are. I mean, these roads are really not in great shape.
Oh, I've chosen a path. Yeah. Lie to a police officer.
Sir? Keep the car running. Sir?
Is this guy, like, the all-time scariest cop?
I don't know, this is my first cop.
What, like ever?
Yeah, I'm not a criminal.
These are kind of... They're not annoying. They're quite likable, actually. Which makes a change for most of these characters, because normally they're really annoying American teenagers.
Hey, you folks want to tell me...
Just
what in the hell you are doing all the way out here this late at night?
Taking in the sun. I'm not going to be a friend.
We're heading up to Hackett's Quarry summer camp. We're new counselors.
You're one night early.
No, we know. But we figured we'd get in early and scope it out. You know, I mean, they know we're coming. We called ahead.
And to be honest, sir, one of us kind of oversold their navigation skills and got us completely lost.
Yeah, Santa Clarita's Diet he was in. It's quite fun, that series. Timothy Oliphant is great in anything.
You're not going to make it to Hackett's Quarry. Not tonight.
Oh, he's Silas, isn't he? He's got to be Silas.
Harbinger Motel. It's the nearest place. You can bunk up there for the night. Okay?
Silas!
I think we're just gonna stick to the plan, sir. I mean, Mr. Hackett knows we're coming, and we called ahead.
No, ma'am, you're gonna head to the Harbinger Motel. Do you understand?
I'm gonna be.
With all due respect, sir, why can't we go to Hackett's Quarry?
Because exactly. I told you to go to the motel.
Okay, I just don't understand what the problem is.
Ma'am, please step out of the vehicle.
Whoa.
What? Mm. Why?
Officer, she didn't do anything.
Oh, he's not trustworthy at all.
If you wouldn't mind stepping out of the vehicle,
he's a well dodgy geese.
Find a map there.
For sure.
Get out with her, mate.
Son, remain in the vehicle.
Oh, fuck off, dude. You're a weirdo. You know, he's probably called Silas. It's Silas the policeman.
So, we...
Oh, that's not creepy.
All right about here.
It's a pencil, anyway. You don't do that with a pencil.
Harbinger Motel.
With a pen.
Is here.
Right, okay. And where was Hackett's Quarry again?
Well, I'm sure the fine folks at the Harbinger Motel can guide you there first thing in the morning.
Go away.
Harbinger Motel. Stay on the road. Watch out for potholes.
Oh, you need like
a
statement?
Have a good night.
Not creepy. Not creepy at all. The game looks lovely.
Why is this guy just sitting there?
Annoyed. Thanks for all your help. That guy was weird. Yeah, that guy was weird.
He was giving me major weirdo
vibes. The dude needed like at least a dozen showers.
Oh my god, I know.
What was up with the thing? Did you see that?
Was it blood?
Nice to meet you.
Oh man.
All right, let's get back on the road.
Yes.
I think I've had enough woodland encounters for one night. Thank you very much.
Agreed. So where's this motel?
Okay, so we're here.
Mm-hmm.
And the motel
for
is
two
here,
Americans.
But we're going.
American teenagers.
What's
they're
there?
Not annoying.
Hackett's Quarry.
How'd you do that?
I don't know, I kind of tricked him into showing you.
Very slick. Are you sure we shouldn't just get to the motel and just
nice.
Listen to this guy's advice?
Honey, you really want to listen to the advice of some creep-ass cop who told us in the middle of the creep-ass woods?
Why do I think that creep-ass cop is going to be walking into shot any minute now?
Yeah. Let's hit the road, shall we?
That's what I thought.
Ma'am?
Well, maybe not.
Oh my god! If he called me ma'am one more time, I was going to shove that badge up his dick hole. Seriously, do I look like a ma'am to you? I got like 20 years before I'm a ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
No, you're a ma'am.
What?
Because cops call everyone ma'am in America.
Debatable.
Easy.
I mean, I'm kind of into ma'ams.
Okay, we're done here.
Interesting. Interesting characters. Not annoying. If these are the main characters, I'll be quite happy with that, because I find some of these characters in these games really annoying. It's just the fact I'm a middle-aged man, like. Hackett's Quarry.
You gotta be kidding me. There's nobody here. We drive all the way the fuck out
Max,
here.
Max, can we just look around before we jump to conclusions?
Did you actually even talk to Mr. Hackett, or did you just leave a message?
Well, what's the difference?
This is the difference.
Hello?
I guess he doesn't check his voicemail.
How was I supposed to know that?
I thought this was set in the 80s,
I mean,
though.
Clearly there's somebody
I have a
here.
Funny feeling
yeah,
this is
just
a...
an abandoned car, and this is a complete waste
Why
of time.
Why would there be an abandoned...
A prologue.
Max.
If this is a prologue,
Max,
then they're both going to die.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
And then it's going to go back into the 80s. Like, I think the game's set in the 80s, which is kind of... this because they're talking about mobile phones. They're talking about leaving, you know, messages on...
Is anybody home?
God, that's beautiful. Hello? Is there anybody in? Hello? 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 Can I see in the window? No. Can't see in the window. Oh, what's that down there? Can't see what that open torch on it. There's nothing. Nothing around there. So remember Withnail and I, where they, where I think Withnail says those are the kind of windows that faces peer in. these are those kind of windows if you're inside. I've had that on the narrowboat. I've been on the cut and I've been, you know, hello, what's that? I've been on the cut and I've, you know, in this really secluded spot and I'm sitting in the saloon. It's about 8 o'clock at night, 9 o'clock at night. Nobody's walked on the towpath for, you know, a couple of hours, sort of. And then suddenly you just sense, like, you sense a presence. And you look, and you see a face looking in. Just somebody being nosy. Just somebody just being nosy, seeing whether anyone's home, or... But that is disconcerting. It's, it really is, because you... Oh, hello. Oh. Ooh. Ooh. Hello. Hello, hello, hello. It's a sofa seat. It's nothing. Oh, what's that? Coffee? coffee mug, book. Somebody's been having a cup of coffee. Oh, come on, we're going to see him. Oh, no, I thought we were going to see some movement then. Well, there's nothing up here.
Laura, there's no one here. Come on.
Just give there? Me one more minute, okay?
What's that light there? What's that down there? What's that? What's that down? What's that? It's a ball. Ain't nothing going on around here. Something down here, though. What's up? Tree walk, fire pit, tree house. So Hackett's quarry, jetty, boathouse. What doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Fun. What doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
What's down there? That looks like something down here. There's a lot, it's lit up. There's got to be something down here. Oh, don't open that. Fucking Leatherface jumps out. Would you? No. You wouldn't. No matter how curious you are, you... Whoa. Well, that's a lot of detail in the eye, right?
Hey!
There.
Hey, are you okay?
Oh, it's not like...
I'll be right back. I'm gonna get some help.
Help? Get the fuck out of there. I need help. That was a little inbred.
Max, get over here.
What's going on?
There's somebody in the bunker. I think they might be stuck.
Yeah, it's the banjo player from Deliverance. Let's just leave
Mr.
now.
Hackett?
I don't know. Just bring some tools so we can break the lock. Hey, I'm back. We're gonna get you out of there.
Hey, me. Maybe
Wait,
he doesn't want to get out of there. Maybe he wants to stay in there. The little,
look, there's someone in there.
The little inbred banjo player from Deliverance.
I'm not seeing anyone.
What? No, look.
I'm looking, I am.
Oh, the detail in the eyes. It's amazing. The pupil and hers pupil. God.
There was definitely someone there.
Okay, so...
Hammer or a wrench? To open that? You gotta go with the wrench, haven't you? Hammer will do shit.
You sure?
So yeah, take the hammer because you know what's gonna... You know what's resigned, confident. Yeah, saw it. See? This is present day. Saw it online.
Yeah, saw it online.
Oh, these are gonna die. They have... This is a prologue. And then they'll introduce annoying characters. Because these aren't that annoying.
You need a hand?
Yeah.
Give her the hammer now. Take the hammer now. Don't drop the hammer. Use that as a weapon. A good wrench around the face will do it. Oh, you don't go down there. Oh, you don't. But if I just turn around and walk away, it won't let me. In real life, I would be like, you go down.
You've seen the Evil Dead, right?
Okay, there's the first
Hello?
In-your-face reference. Ashy, smashy. Oh, get out, guys.
Hey, be careful.
If this is present day, it would mean that 20 years ago, Scream... Oh, hello. 20 years ago... It's like Scream never happened. It's like the postmodern horror. Postmodern horror never happened. Mirror, signal. Oh, what's that? Nothing. Ian.
Silas.
Silas, a surname? Was it Ian Silas? Bloodied collar. This bloodied collar looks to be too big for a dog. What kind of dog be called Ian anyway? May be into sadomasochism. Although I'm thinking, why am I...
Max?
The John Landis reference at the start has got me, and the dog collar has got me. That was probably a werewolf, because everything in these kind of games are so blatantly in your face, and having... I don't know.
Maybe it was a possum or something.
No, there was someone here, I swear.
Hey.
Is it a full moon?
It's been kind of a night, you know?
I don't think it's a full moon.
Let's just get to the motel. We can come back here first thing in the morning. We can check everything out, but... I mean, you must be exhausted. I know I am. I think our imagination...
Oh, fuck me.
Max?
Oh, it's a fucking werewolf. That's a werewolf.
Max!
He's called Max. They've already referenced Landis University. Oh, he's been bitten. Has he been bitten? Max! Is this a werewolf game?
This what?
Oh, these are dead. These are dead. This prologue is... That's a werewolf. Landis is a prologue and they're both going to die.
I think I'm bleeding a lot.
Leave him? Yeah, sod you, Max. Path chosen. Well, as opposed to the horrible girlfriend path, horrible wife or girlfriend or whatever they are. Just leave them. Just leave them. Oh. Is he going to turn into a werewolf? She's doing good. She's getting him out. She's getting him out. It's a werewolf. What? Oh, it's Sam. It's Sam Raimi. It's Ted Raimi again. It's appropriate.
Does this look like the goddamn Harbinger Motel to you?
Prologue. Something tells me the game now goes back into the 80s. Good prologue, actually. Good prologue.
Fly me to the moon. And let me play among the stars. Let me know what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars.
In other words, just imagine if that was the end of the game. The choices I make then just stop the game. That's it. That's the end. In other words, darling, kiss me. It's a werewolf game. It's a werewolf game. It was a full moon. they're being very subtle and then in your face with the John Landis stuff and the dog collar. Too big for a dog.
Not that kind of dog.
Wow. Good.
Hello, my friend.
There's Grace.
Welcome to the show.
Twin Peaks.
We are friends, aren't we? I've waited for you.
Oh, she's that. There used to be a guy that did this in these games.
So I do hope our time together proves enlightening. There's no need to worry. I'm here to help you. Think of me as your guide into the unknown. It's exciting. Yes.
It's a formula that they've used many times in the past.
But if you're brave enough, if you let me help you, I can help you. We can help each other. This is the card you found. The Fool. I wonder who this is. We all know a fool when we see one, don't we?
Yes, we do, Grace. Yes,
innocence and freedom. All recklessness and risk-taking. Spontaneity. Actions without thought, but the consequences to match. Think. Think, and don't get burnt. I can show you more if you'd like me to.
Yeah, go for it, Grace.
This is what might come to pass. A possible future. A path yet unchosen. Look here, look here.
In a crystal ball.
There are secrets out there, you know. Secrets and lies. Paths
good
to
morning,
uncover.
Ethan. Although I don't think it's a reference.
I can shed light, if you let me. Help me help you. And remember, what doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
So there's normally a guy that does that in the three games that I've played from this company before. Good actor, actually, that. This has got to be now. It's got to be like, say, something like 1980s or something. Hackett's Quarry Forever, Chapter 1. Nothing bad ever happens in the day. We all know that. In fact, the hardest thing to do is to make a horror film through the day, which is why most horror films take place at night. There are the odd few that really do. I'm thinking of the Long Weekend horror film in broad daylight. Australian horror movie, good film. Hackett's Quarry, summer camp.
Ladies. Peace and love.
See you later, kids.
Yeah, Hackett's Quarry forever.
Oh, God. Here they are. Here's the annoying ones. The first ones were really, they were actually really good. I'm just,
you know how many hearts are broken on the last day of summer camp? It's like a romance apocalypse.
Reflective. You never know. They'll get over it. They'll get over it.
Yeah, well, I mean, they're just kids. You know, they'll get over it.
Uh-huh. Like they'll get over Emma.
What? That's not the same thing.
Oh, so that's not why you're in a bad mood.
I'm not in a bad... Oh, you know what? We had our last night together, and we're cool.
Oh, yeah. So cool that you're never going to see your special little boo-boo bear ever again.
Jesus Christ, you heard that?
Oh, come on, dude. The cabin walls are made of Band-Aids and rat turds.
Okay, I get it. Okay, quit it.
Hi, Emma.
Hey.
I don't think this is set in the 80s. Supposed to be like
okay,
an 80s
this
thing.
Is, you've heard of spatial awareness before,
yeah,
right?
Spatial awareness is for nerds. Be a lamb and grab the last couple of bags, will you?
Yes, boss.
Say hi to Emma for me.
Friggin' lecture with the script,
yes,
aren't we?
Yes, I am.
We're gonna get toxic masculinity at some point. I thought this game was set in the 80s, which either makes it very heavy-handed with references and some know-it-all kind of person that corrects people in a futuristic, politically correct manner. But no, spatial awareness. That's a. This is so modern. Oh well.
Jake, bags, focus.
Don't like her. Just gonna go over here. What's this? Oh, what have we got? What have we got, Jake? What's
oh, hey, this is Emma's.
Path chosen. She told me to do the bags, didn't she? Who's Emma? His girlfriend. Nice lighting effects. Very good. Very good lighting effects. What's this? It's the map we saw earlier on.
What doesn't kill you will make you stronger. Not in the mood, sign.
Not in the mood. I've forgotten what she asked me to do. What did you ask me to do? Oh, you asked me to get the bags. What's she going to do again when I say it?
Jacob, go upstairs. Jacob, get bag. Caitlin moves on with her goddamn life.
Oh, Caitlin. You're making me want to ask you again. Caitlin?
Jacob, go upstairs. Jacob, get back. Caitlin moves on with their goddamn life.
Nobody predicted that you would just keep doing that until it and they would like program it to say something completely different. I'm just gonna go around and down here anyway. Oh, there's a guy down here. It's a weird place to hang out, especially considering what happened here. Hello, mate. Caitlin's told me to go and get the bags, but I thought I'd come over and chat to you.
Hey, what do you listen to? Before they knew it, the whole place was up in smoke. Good to know.
He'd rather. No, you're not going yet, Jake. You're gonna check out these doors. Well, we can't do anything there. Can we annoy this guy again? Is it gonna be different this time, or is it gonna be exactly the same? It's exactly the same.
Hello?
It's a shame.
Whatever, man.
Oh, no, it's a bit different. And what about for the final? What about the test? The real test is the third time. This is normally the time. Normally the programmers are like, I mean, he's going to give up. They're going to give up on the second time. But what about the third time? Does he turn around and say something? You unlocked a secret. He won't.
Hello?
He'll say whatever. Whatever.
Whatever, man.
Oh, wasted opportunity there, game designers. Wasted opportunity, especially for somebody who, like myself, who kind of likes to antagonize computer game characters. That's just something I enjoy doing every so often. Caitlin, I'm going to go get the bags upstairs, okay? That's what she wanted me to do like 10 minutes ago. Oh, just one more thing.
Jesus Christ. Hi. Hey, are you guys gonna help with the bags or what?
Oh, you know, I was actually just working on fixing the door. It's
Dylan, come
it's
on.
Broken.
Dylan, please.
I can't. It's
I gotta get the last bags
What's
in there. Come
wrong
on
with this thing. It's just
Dylan, please.
Sorry, bro.
Cool. Thanks, guys.
It's quite funny. What's that? Hackett's Quarry. I've already seen that. It was a sign on the way in. Oh. Clue. Hackett's Quarry Summer Camp established way back in 1953 and it's still going strong today. Nearly 70 years on. Oh, yeah. 70 years. Well, it is over 70 years now. But the game came out 2 years ago. So this is... Like he didn't with the spatial awareness. It's like you can't even question whether this is modern day or the 80s. I mean, it's clearly. Hello. What have we got here? Oh.
Oh, skill.
You can go back out again, can you?
Double skill.
Come back one more time. That was good. Give him credit. Triple skill? No. No triple skill. They're definitely... Oh, it's a different angle, though, each time I do it. That's kind of cool. Oh, Jake, you're a one. The double skill was... The double skill thing was quite cool, I must admit. I did see something down here, but I think it was just the meter. The door's going to be locked again, isn't it? Yeah.
Dipshits bolted it? Really?
One more time. Whatever. People will get really annoyed with the way I play games. But games like this, they're designed to wander about and be silly, you know. I'm not happy unless at least half of these characters are dead at some point. Oh, that's the plaque. Probably for doing stupid shit like this or reactional stuff that I'm just too slow to react to and I die. But stupid shit like this gets a lot of deaths, especially in these games. Right. Oh, what's that down there? Is that something? No! I'm looking down at the cup. Oh, that was annoying. I was looking down at the cup. Look, that cup is highlighted. Look at it, it's flashing. It's because of the light, I think. What's that? What have we got here?
Ugh. Horror. I hate horror.
Well, aren't you the lucky one? The wall, cat. No. Nothing down here. Nothing here. Nothing. It's just supposed to get the bags. That's all I'm supposed to do, isn't it? Just get the bags. Just get the bags, Jake. Carl, what are you doing, mate? Whole room. Keep out. Why? Counselors only. Yeah. Am I going in? No. Oh, here's a guy. Is there anything in our area though? Before I speak to him. On the tables. No. Nothing by the fire. Can I open these doors now? Nope. Nothing around it. Nothing at all apart from a sulky man on the stairs.
Okay, really, dude? Locking me out?
Okay, in my defense, A, it was Dylan's idea, and...
He's Australian.
Two, it was really funny.
Oh, yeah, right. Is that right?
I don't write the rules, man.
Okay, whatever. Look, are you gonna help me with the bags or what?
Nah, I gotta stay here and wait for Mr. H to return our cell phone. Sorry.
Jesus Christ. Okay, and why are the stairs blocked?
Well, apparently it's to keep raccoons and other pesky varmints from ransacking the place. Mr. H's words, not mine.
Oh! Boring!
Oh, there's a dark corridor. Bound to go down there at some point. What's in here?
Is that you, Dylan?
I can only deal with one shit at a time, Jacob.
What about if I knock it again, just to really annoy him? Nah, he's been a dickhead. Nothing down here? No, it's gonna be down the dark hallway, isn't it? Yeah, down the dark hallway we go. What's that sound? Oh. Water. Nothing down there. What am I supposed to do here? Hello? Where am I supposed to go? Can I go back up here? Can I go up the stairs? No. What am I supposed to do here? Have I missed something? Is that where I came in? Yeah, that's where I came in. What's on here? These doors open. Yeah, those doors open. What's in here? Oh. Tarot card. Temperance. Temperance. To be balanced, to consume in moderation, or to indulge in excess. Temperance. Take it or leave it, but remember, sometimes with temperance comes deferred gratification. It'll be an achievement for getting all those tarot cards. Look at the sunshine. So beautiful. Fire kills. There was a little hint of fire, if I remember, in the tarot reading before. Just doing something in the car and everything caught fire.
Man, that's a bad place to get stuck.
That's not... Is that going to come back into the game? Is that going to come back into the game at some point? Somebody going to get stuck in there? Can't see anything. Monday, burgers. Tuesday, hot dogs. Wednesday, cheesesteak. Cheesesteak. That's a weird thing that Americans do with cheese and steak. Thursday, pizza. Tater tots. Oh, I hate that word. It makes potatoes sound like they're for, like, a five-year-old. Pot roast. I had one of them once. Really disappointing. Fajitas. Classic. Biscuits and gravy. Well, for dinner? Jesus. Have you got an overweight problem? Not all Americans are overweight. And who am I to talk? I didn't look down there, did I? Oh, there's... I thought it was a wrench. No. Well, this has been a pointless little venture wandering about, hasn't it? Is this the place I go out? Yeah, I go out here. I'm supposed to get the bags, aren't I? Where are the bags? She's gonna kick off when I come back down here, isn't she? I can't find the bags. She's gonna ask me again.
Jacob, go upstairs. Jacob, get bag. Caitlin moves on with her goddamn life.
Unbelievable. Where's the bag? Where is the bag? I thought she's going upstairs. I guess these are the stairs, but I thought with the staircase being out, it's like, I can't get your bag because the staircase is out. I must have missed a bag somewhere. There's no bag in here, is there? Is there a bag? What kind of bag am I looking for? Ah, there's a cloakroom over there. Is there a bag in here? How'd you get in there? This way? No. Excuse me, mate. I need to find a bag. Has anyone got a bag? Is there a bag? What's that? Oh, that's the horror novels. Where the fuck's the bag? bag. I think the prologue was better. Where's the bag? Where is there a bag in it? There's a bag over there. Something on the table. Is that a bag? No. Tissues. No. Where's the bag? Where's the bag? Dude, get out of my way so I can go. Miska. Oh my god. Oh my god. I'm stuck on probably the easiest thing. Or I'm missing something. There's a bag. It's out of the box. That's the box. And none of these doors open. None of them open. Something down here and I couldn't see it. No. No. Where's the bag? Dude, get off the stairs, mate. Where's the bag? Is there a bag? Have you seen a bag? I can't see a bag. Bag. Go upstairs and get the bag. This is annoying. Bear. Do you want the bear? I'll take the bear instead. Bag. 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 Belgium. Oh god, you're all in here. It's been so quiet for an hour. I didn't realise. Can anyone tell me where the bag is? I can't find the bag. Find horror novels. There's a horror novel. Jose Rodriguez. Show text. Slaughter by Sunrise. Blood Castle by Elliot Sparks. It's dumb. There's no bag. There's nothing up here. Bag. 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 I am visible, says Steposaur. You are visible, mate. You are visible. Are you visible on the chat? Now we've got people chatting. I don't. I'm lost. I'm genuinely lost by this. I don't see a bag anywhere up here. Must be on the porch. It must be on the porch. Let's go out and see whether I can. Definitely no bag in there. There's definitely no bag in there. There's definitely no bag in there. Bag. How are you, old school fool? And I see we've got Boo Marcel Boy. Hello, Boo Marcel Boy. Have you played this game? I just seem to be stuck on the most mundane thing here. Go upstairs and get the bag. I've gone upstairs. I can't go right upstairs because the stairs are out. So where's the bag? It's the dumbest thing. Oh my god. It's the dumbest thing. I am not even going to look at how to get the bag on YouTube. If you have to check a YouTube video because you can't complete the very first thing. Can I go up here? Ah! Oh! Back. So, I mean, either I'm blind or... Oh my god. Literally 10 minutes of walking around looking for this fucking bag. I'm just going to tell her to get the bag herself next time. She's been waiting here like 15 minutes with me screwing about.
Great. All by yourself, huh?
Yep.
Guess you're gonna have to get used to that.
Oh my god, you are so mean.
At least I'm honest.
Oh, okay, here we go.
Okay, you're not telling me the whole truth about you and Emma, are you, son?
Oh, even though I don't like it.
Okay, so now I'm the one who's not telling the whole story, huh?
Oh, well, this is the bait I just gotta take, Jake. Oh, sorry, I just got so distracted about that rhyme, I forgot what we were...
Oh, no. You were telling me how you totally have a thing for Ryan.
Wait, are we talking about Ryan, the sailing instructor with the sexy brooding loner thing that totally doesn't do anything for me at all?
Smug. Mischievous. Smug.
Knew it.
Who said I was hiding that?
I'm not. I'm just saying, you know, I feel like if you really did like the guy, you would have made a move by now.
So she really just dumped her ass, huh?
I don't... Okay. Her whole thing is like, how are we going to make this work? Different schools, blah, blah, blah. My whole thing is like, you know, maybe long distance, blah, 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 blah. And she was just like, Jacob.
She gave you the look, huh?
Yeah, do not pass go.
Man, she has got you wrapped all the way around that dainty little finger of hers. How does she do it?
Brave. It's just a fling. Defeated. Maybe I like it. Brave.
Oh, but I mean, seriously, come on, brave. She's right. It's just like a stupid summer fling. What else did I think was going to happen?
Let's see. Love, stability, engagement, marriage, house.
She's annoying.
Affair,
she's annoying.
Kid,
she's annoying.
Divorce, loneliness, child support, visitation loss.
She's gonna die.
Surprise reconciliation, emptiness, retirement.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Nursing home, and finally, dying in each other's arms and then being buried in each other's arms like those 1,000-year-old skeletons they dug up in Rome or something. That kind of in the ballpark? Oh, shit, I'm sorry. That was Ryan and me. Let me see. Ah, here it is. Yours just says Roadhead. Oh, actually, that's just a generic all-men list.
Well, that seems legit.
Oh, I don't like the dialogue in this game.
So are we sure that this old rust bucket's roadworthy?
We'll take a look. It better be. One more night in the great outdoors might actually kill me.
Hey, it doesn't kill you. So it'll make you stronger. As
well. Well, I haven't killed you yet. You're still pretty pathetic.
Hey, shut up.
Yeah. Is she gonna come back at that? No, she's not. She's not coming back at that.
Okay, so, total hypothetical, but if I was like a huge asshole and I wanted to break down the van so we'd have to spend another night here, what exactly would I need to do?
Well, you'd probably break the fuel line or, I don't know.
Take the battery.
Rip out the rotor arm. And yes, that would make you a total asshole.
Okay, and what does a rotor arm look like again?
It's like an arm that's all rotary. You know, it's under the little black dome with the leads poking out. Jake, you do realize that even if we somehow did get stuck out here, one more night with Emma wouldn't make a difference. Trust me, chick's made up her mind.
Yeah. Sure. Guess we'll just have to find out.
Brake fuel line, still rotor arm. Let's go with the rotor arm. Make it really obvious. Path chosen. You chose the
buddy?
Rotor arm.
I'll put you right back tomorrow. No harm, no foul.
There is a logic. There was a logic with the rotor arm, because the other one is that the fire
here,
thing
my dudes.
That they burn. It's they something like to do with that fire. Something. So I
hey,
chose
Jacob.
The rotor arm.
No, dude, please, don't.
Go long.
Oh, dick.
What dickhead?
Boom. Oh, there it is.
Oh man, good save.
Jesus.
Oh. Ooh, I wish I had some singles.
Freaks. Surrounded by freaks. Oh, thank God. I'm gonna get the whole no technology thing, but take me back, world.
You would have thought Mr. H could have, like, charged up our phones, like, a little bit.
Nothing's ever your fault.
I don't know how to.
You know,
to
you should
that.
Really just save it for emergencies only. Unless, of course, is being dumped an emergency?
Oh, Ben.
She went up in my estimate a little bit then. Annoyed, back off dipshit, friendly. I'll go be friendly.
Okay, well, at least I had a relationship this summer.
Ooh, damn, now we burn. Yeah, well, maybe not everyone is looking for a hookup.
Okay, let's all put our little dicks away and get this show on the road, huh?
Where's everybody else?
Why would I know that?
Sometimes you know stuff I don't.
Look, I don't even know how to respond to that.
You say, Nick, you're way smarter than me, and you're a super hot stud who gets any chick he wants.
Okay, yeah.
New Zealand. Slightly Maori. Slightly Maori. New Zealander? I can't do a New Zealand accent. I kind of wish this game was set in the 80s, because the dialogue would be a bit different. It's very knowing at the moment. Abigail, Hackett's Quarry Camp Cabins. It's very knowing. That's very good. Looks a little bit like Susan Day from 1970s. It's a beautiful looking game, I give it that. The dialogue's a bit.
Hey there, Party Bear.
Supermassive games.
Status report? We are officially empty nesters. High five up top.
If I hadn't done that,
you're about to get your phone back, aren't you? Let's go collect our bags and away from this mosquito-infested backwoods dump. Doors locked, bags inside. Fuck me. Yep. Well, it's obvious what we have to do here. Find someone with a key? Shape our destiny. And by shape our destiny, I mean shape our way through this crappy lock and grab our bags.
Leave bags. Break in. Leave bags.
Are you serious? That's called breaking and entering. No, that's called retrieving our lawfully owned possessions. Why don't we just find Mr. Hackett and have
She's
him
not,
open it back?
We're not going to leave the, we're not gonna leave the bags,
like
are we?
3 feet away. Sorry. As soon as we get back to the lodge, we'll find Mr. Hackett and have him help us get our bags. Fine.
Oh, did. Okay.
Okay, well, fine. I'm just going to do a quick sweep then to make sure we didn't forget anything.
Okay, there was a path there.
Knock yourself out.
Interesting. Emma thinks you're overreacting. The red hair. What is going on in this game? So, I'm just trying to work it out. So it's present day. That thing that happened, the prelude. We'll disregard that for the minute. So you've got these random camp counselors. Are they at the end of their season? Are they going? They want to leave now. I don't really understand. I don't really understand what they're all doing. Are they all together? Are these together with the guys and the other? Yeah. I don't know. But they're all Mr. Hackett. So he's the owner clearly, because it's the quarry. Oh, what's this?
Dylan is not going to be happy that the case was not this year. I'll tell Chris about it when we see him.
Oh, I didn't get to analyze it. Yeah, I want to analyze it. Oh, I can't now. There's an old tape recorder. Is this the 80s? It's a little bit confusing. There's references to like record players and tape players and stuff, but it's, you know, still very much the dialogue is I've been lifting old floorboards to lay new. I'm buckled and broken, mate. Have you been doing DIY as well? I literally have given myself a Friday where I'm just playing the game. And I say I've had this game for like a year and a half. I bought it in a Steam sale. Never played it. It's interesting. Had a good opening. Give it credit, but this is. I mean, I've not given it a chance. I'm gonna give it a chance. But yeah, I've been doing a lot of DIY, as you know, mate. There's lots of things that are. I've also been up and down to Devon a fair amount. So I did plan on doing a live stream on Wednesday, actually, a gaming stream, and then I just thought, oh, sod it. I'll do one at the weekend, but DIY. Yeah. It's, it takes it out of you. It really does. So you've been doing, what have you been doing? What are you doing to your house? Are you changing something around? I'm having the flooring ripped up in the next 3 days. Old school. Not right to this place, but up to the bathroom, the head. I'm having it ripped up. And then I'm having the dinette dismantled, so I'm going to be on an airbed for the next 3 weeks. While I sand down all the walls in the saloon and the galley, and paint them, paint the ceiling, paint the radiators, all that's happening. I can't believe how much they cost somebody to come in and put a new vinyl floor down for me. It's like the vinyl floor itself is, you can, you know, I want fairly good quality and would be walking on it for the next 10 years. But so that's like £1,000 for, I think it's something like £60 per square inch. Per square inch, that would be per meter. Square meter. So I think it comes to about £1,000. But then I got to have somebody cut it and install it, because I can't do that. I can't do that. It's gonna be another £600 to do that. And they're gonna do it in a day, but I've got to get somebody to do it right. Because what am I doing here in this? What am I doing here in this game? I'm just wandering about. What am I doing? Checking out every single. What's up there? God. Oh hello! Look at that. Wow, that's beautiful, isn't it? That's beautiful. It almost matches your red hair. Those red clay cliffs. So yeah, lots of stuff. Yes, how's the renovate going? We haven't had a lounge for 3 years. Got the floor, fireplace. Oh, God. But have you got used to it? What have we got here? This is just some more steps for you to sit on. Oh. Is this Mr. Hackett?
It's going to be weird not waking up to Dylan's morning announcements.
Yeah, so this is the end of there. Dylan. So it's the end of their camp season. Oh, crow.
Hey! You stop that!
What was that? What was he doing? Can I get up there? What was that crow doing? No, no. So you'd look. No, don't look in the same place. Look what the crow was doing. No, you can't. Okay, not just. The crow was tapping the phone line, and I can't climb up there. Oh, what was that? Is that something down there? No. No, nothing around there, nothing around there. Victorian fireplace with black side tiles gave the tiles a scrape and revealed Mucci's evening reverie. I can't read that because there's a heart in the way. Reverie scene, beautiful Art Nouveau. Ooh, lovely. That sounds very, very nice. I'm having my stove taken out. He's taking the stove out, he's taking the dinette out, he's taking the floor up, he's putting in 4 new leisure batteries. I'm not going with lithium. I'm going with traditional carbon batteries, partly to do with the money. And he's putting an MPG controller, he's putting in an extra alternator on the engine, and he's putting in an inverter. And it's all going to be about £4,000, I think, at the end of the day. It's a lot of bloody money that's coming out of my account, but gotta get it done. I don't mind, like, so, like, I don't mind being, not having a, you know, sleeping on the floor, on a airbed. I don't mind that. While everything is kind of being done, I don't mind that. Because I can, with everything gone in there, I can kind of, like, paint the walls and stuff and do everything I need to do there. So I don't mind it being sort of up to a point where I can then start furnishing it and... But there's a lot of stuff to do, and I'm running out of time because it's all got to be done by July 14th. The floor's got to be done by July 14th, because I've got friends coming up to help me move the boat. So I don't want just plywood on the floor. I've got to be proud of something. Although in theory, I'll be asking them to take their shoes off before they walk on the floor. It's black and white floor as well. Right, I think that I'm not going to give up here, despite the fact that this is the most boring part of the game. Because I haven't quite got an idea what's going on yet. There seems to be these two groups of people, and they've all just reached the end of their camping season as counsellors. And they all look like they're going home. I don't know whether these two girls know the other guys. I get the impression that they don't. But I don't know. I'm sure I've missed something here. But I'm just gonna instigate some dialogue. Oh look, there's a little camping caddy.
Ready to roll?
Yeah, let's get out of here. Enthusiastic.
Let's do it.
I'm sure there's something there I missed. Have you ever been
time
in one of these?
Let loose and vamoose this caboose.
Oh god.
How are you so dramatic?
Vamoose this caboose.
Confident. It's just acting. It's what the people want.
So you're faking it?
I mean, in a way, faking it is just being yourself, but louder. You should try it sometime. You never know who you might impress.
Nah. It's too late now anyway.
For what? You and Nick? You never know unless you put yourself out there.
Oh.
Oh, wow! Oh.
Did he miss that one?
Nice steering.
Defender, it's a good game.
Jinkies. Okay, so
they put them in there because you know that.
Put myself out there.
They know that the dialogue is so mundane that people are just not listening to it.
He's actually really sweet.
He just switched off. Like,
then why'd you quit it?
Summer fling. We're going to school like 4 seconds away. He gets it.
This is
But that's us. You and Nick could be different. When do you get his handle? Hit him up.
Oh, I already have his email.
So they are all.
Gave to us on the first day.
Wait, they are all together.
Email? Are you 93? What's wrong with email?
Oh god, I hate postmodernism. Shite that stems into these games. There's nothing wrong with email.
Oh, but the lodge is that way.
Go right here.
Why?
Come on, scenic route. One last victory lap around the camp.
No, going to the lodge. We're going to the lodge. Stuff your scenic route.
We should really get back.
Boo. Thumbs down.
Everyone's waiting for us.
Nick isn't gonna leave without
saying I am a party pooper. I am.
Shit, Abby!
Well, don't run the squirrel over.
Too close.
Sorry, squirrel dude. My girl here is on her way to ask a guy out for the first time, like, ever.
Emma!
Couldn't let her squirrel out of it.
I am going to throw you out of the cart.
I deserve that.
Yeah, you do. Yeah, you really do. I'm gonna have a lot of fun killing these people off. Not all of them. There are a couple. I quite like the one with the dark hair and the green. Definitely. I don't try and kill them off. It's just...
Don't worry, Jacob.
I might make
you.
More stupider reactions when it comes to controlling them.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, idiot.
And there's a lot of
phone chargers anymore.
There's a lot of candidates in this game.
Patchy's balls.
Your balls are patchy.
What?
That
no.
I don't like.
It's okay. I'll just go get some juice from Mr. H before.
And I'm just talking. Is your balls patchy? Ew. What is the dialogue in this game? It's clearly not for a middle-aged man like me.
Hey, Nick.
Hey, where were you guys?
Wouldn't you like to know? Ignore her, please.
She's the first one to die.
Let's go.
There's no one here that I really like.
Mr.
No
H locked them in the cabin already.
Why? To keep out bears?
Apparently.
Yeah, they could all die. Sarcastic. Bears can be a problem. Questioning. Why didn't you break in? I'm going to question my own logic of why we didn't break in.
Well, why didn't you just break in?
Okay, because Dylan thinks that would have been a good idea. That confirms we did the right thing.
Ooh.
That's good.
I like my ideas.
Oh, that was a good
Hey, has
that.
Anyone seen Ryan?
Oh, yeah, he's probably off being all brooding and mysterious and alluring somewhere.
I'm here.
What were you doing under there? Having a little knee party?
I was listening to a podcast, actually.
Podcast.
Oh, podcast. Nice, that's cool.
That's very post.
What's it about? Modern
podcast. What's it about? Protective, mind your own business, friendly. It's about me.
Yeah, what's it about? Is it about me?
Think I was listening to a podcast about you.
Okay, if anyone you got a podcast about them, it'd be me.
Terrible thought.
Yeah, if there was a podcast called How to Look and Smell Like a Butt.
Oh my god, you are so childish.
At least I don't look and smell like a butt.
Oh, no, it's a paranormal podcast. This episode was actually about this place, weirdly enough. The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
The who of the what's it where now?
God,
what's the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
It's terrible.
You don't know about
it?
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
If I did, would I be asking, dumbass?
Tell her about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
I don't think she wants to know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Can we just please stop saying the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
It's just this campfire story for the kids. It's, they're supposedly an old woman who died in a fire.
Right now, Bobby Davro would
haunts the woods.
Make this game much more exciting.
For a lost baby boy.
Even the story, even the backstory is cliche.
Or whatever, and this figure that floats around, you know, textbook ghost stuff. Some people say that if she catches you alone, she'll try to turn you into her son.
I was going to say, turn you into stone.
Kill you, or something. I don't know. It's never really been clear. Anyways, Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Give me that.
Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
It's right here in the podcast, man.
Cool story, bro.
Supportive. You should have seen the kids. Defensive. Better than yours.
Seriously, though, you should have seen the first time he told the story to the kids at the campfire. They were scarred for life.
I mean, not for life.
You gotta be careful with this stuff, man. This shit's true.
Come on, dude, bullshit.
What's the holdup, Hacketeers?
Nearly done, Mr. H.
Hop to it.
That's David Arquette.
Get those butts in gear.
Coulda, woulda, if our bags weren't locked up.
What's that? Sounded like you said, of course, Mr. H. We're on it, Mr. H.
Sorry, Mr. Hackett, but our bags...
He's the only one I want to save.
We're really
just David Arquette. Everyone else
Ryan,
can die.
He's trying to scare the pants off our butts with his
he's
weird
probably the murderer
stories.
As well.
Okay. Enough with all the butts. And
what's
this about ghost stories?
H of H's Q.
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry. I was just...
Oh, for Pete's sake, Ryan.
Hey, you still have the van key, Mr. H?
Well, yes, I do. You know, I'd lose my head if it wasn't stuck on. Back to the office I go. Give me a hand, would you, Ryan?
Oh, okay.
Yo, Mr. H.
What's up, DJ Dylan?
Any chance I could get a little charge? I want to have some tunes for the road.
No can do.
Understanding, annoyed. Oh, he seems like he's going to get annoyed, isn't he?
Go come on, that's like super unchill.
Hey, dude, I'm like the chillest flippin' bro in the whole world, man.
I just need some tunes sounds for the ride,
like,
man.
Sounds like the dude.
All right, that's enough.
5 minutes? Like 5 minutes, that's all I need.
He's the sort
man.
Of guy. The reason why I respond like that is he's the sort of...
Okay, yeah, I know, but I was just...
He's the sort of guy that literally...
Let me
do
the van,
that.
Okay?
And he's the sort of guy that generally gets, like, killed off about the third person.
So, Chris, I'm actually glad we got a moment to talk.
Uh-oh. I'm not fired, am I?
No, it's just, you know, about the whole thing with the...
Hold that thought, partner. I'm gonna have to take this.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Sorry.
He's Hello? The least annoying one of the counselors. Listen to podcast eavesdrop. He's the sort of guy that wouldn't eavesdrop. He's gonna listen to his podcast.
Sucks about the whole people dying thing. That's cold. I'm sorry, but you're the one trying to make it about ghosts and shit.
Right. Speaking of, this is where the reports come in. People claim to hear the sound of the burnt trees and the pained, yearning whispers of the woman as she still to this day.
Sorry about that, bud. Sorry about that, bud. Didn't mean to push you out like that.
Gonna keep him a bit more elusive. Because he's David Arquette. He doesn't have to have his character explained.
You need a hand looking for the keys?
No. End of summer. Busy, busy. You know. Anyway, you were asking me?
Oh, yeah. It was just the whole animation school thing, what you thought I should do.
Right.
You know... Listen, whether or not I should like, leave my sister with my grandparents.
Hey, Mr.
Allen.
I
have to live on campus, you know. And my mom's not exactly around, so I wouldn't want to leave Sarah on her own. You know, our family's small enough as it is.
Well, family is important, Ryan.
Family
Dang
is important.
It.
Frustrated. This is important to me. Concerned. Is everything okay? Clearly, I'm going to ask that.
Is everything okay?
Because you're acting a bit weird.
You got a hot date tonight?
Oh boy. If you only knew. Ryan, I told you to make sure everyone was ready. What happened?
They don't really listen to me.
Then you gotta make them listen, bud.
I can.
Bud?
I mean, shoot, come on. No time to get their bags now.
For real? I don't think the girls are gonna like that.
We'll ship them along in a few days.
So, what did you need me for?
You're one of my favorite counselors, Ryan. You know that. One of the good ones.
He is one of the good ones. I can tell.
But do you know how many calls I get from parents, letter after letter, these terrified kids that they send home?
Huh. I didn't realize that.
Believe it or not, scaring kids away from sleepaway camp is kind of bad for business. So maybe just... ease up on the ghost stories.
Sorry, I didn't realize it was such a big deal.
Gotta understand the repercussions of your actions, Buster. It's a big part of being a counselor, a leader.
It is.
Yeah.
I should imagine it
Just
is.
Just stick to kumbaya next time, okay?
What's that?
You guys don't do kumbaya anymore? Good grief. I'm outgrowing my own cliches.
Oh, that was a good bit of dialogue. Outgrowing my own cliches.
Chris, what's going on?
I just want to get you guys safely out of Dodge before the sun goes down.
Dodge. That's a good old term as well, isn't it? Inquisitive.
Why?
It's getting dark, Ryan, and it's not safe to... drive in the dark. And safety is the first step towards fun.
What?
Just give me a minute. Where in the good goddamn are they?
This is my favorite interaction in the game so far.
Will you say goodbye to Caleb and Kaylee for me? They sort of just snuck off.
Well, you'll see him again next year. Caleb works at the scrapyard during the off-season, and Kaylee, well, she's still figuring out what she wants to do. She's got her whole life ahead of her.
That's a real photo.
They both just come and go as they please, really. Teenagers, am I right?
Actually, could have used the help packing up since we were short-staffed.
Hey, you guys seem to manage all right. But I'll tell them both you were sad you missed them. Unlocked the van, put the keys in my pocket, came in the office.
Put them in the coffee cup.
Right where I left them. Let's skedaddle.
He's a little bit like a stoner. Both of them a little bit like stoners, but...
Make sure they're all ready to go. For real this time.
Wait, how did you get your phone back before the rest of us?
I never turned it in.
You shouldn't have turned it off before you handed it in, Dylan. Them's the rules, you noob.
I try not to dwell on the past, man.
Good. Because it's time to dwell in the minivan. Get on with our respective lives. Move it, let's go.
Hey, what about our bags?
Emma, I'm gonna have to ship them to you tomorrow.
Hell no, no, I am not leaving without...
It's the way it's gotta be. Come on, Jacob, start her up. What's the problem?
Rotor motor's gone.
I think there's something wrong with the engine, Mr. H.
Why did he want to stay here? Just because he wanted to get with his woman?
Yeah, dude, it's just like kaput.
All right, let me try.
That ain't gonna work, mate.
Dude, I'm telling you, all right, it's busted.
Well, maybe you're doing it wrong.
Well, maybe you're doing it wrong.
Oh, you're a fucking idiot.
Dude?
Enough, yeah. Both of you. Shit, come on.
All right,
come
dude, on. Chill, dude. God.
Oh, some of these are just really annoying characters.
Damn it! I thought I told you kids to check everything.
No, we did. It should be working.
Yeah, well, coulda and shoulda doesn't mean it is, does it?
Oh.
Damn it!
He knows something's up, doesn't he? He knows something. Is this when it would have caught fire if I had taken the other thing?
Okay. Okay.
Look, it's not that big of a deal, okay? We'll just spend one more night here.
No! No! Just stop. Let me think.
Anger management.
Okay. Damn it.
It's a bit like Sean Penn there from...
You're right, you're right.
1990,
yeah.
Sean Penn.
What?
Yeah, you're right.
Oh.
Hey, Brian, come here for a sec. Make sure that everybody is inside the lodge for tonight. Lock the doors. No one in, no one out. No one. Got it?
Okay.
I'll be back first thing in the morning, and we'll get you all on the road. You just have to keep everyone inside. Can you promise me you'll do that?
Like he's got that authority. They already treat him like shit. I think he'd have
Wait,
that.
We have to stay inside until tomorrow? Why? Where are you going?
Ryan, I need you to trust me. Like I'm trusting you. Can you do that?
Yeah. But it's a little bit strange, mate.
And for God's sake, keep the noise down!
Fleeing the scene, sir. Are you aware of what's gonna happen here when you leave?
So, what was that about?
He said to stay inside, that we're not leaving until the morning.
Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? What are we supposed to do?
Well, we should go inside, like he said.
Play tic-tac-toe.
We could go inside until morning.
Yeah.
Or we could do something else.
Insistent.
No. We should really listen to what Chris told us to do. Of course.
Who cares what Chris told us to do?
Oh, you're gonna die, mate. Because I'm gonna make sure you die.
P-A-R-T. Why the fuck not? Alright, it seems like the stars have aligned for us, no?
Okay.
One last epic bonfire blowout for all time.
Yeah, we'll do that. Yeah, you do that. While everyone else stays in.
Oh, dude. Fuck yes, I'm in, Nick.
Oh, you're dead as well. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm in.
Yeah, he's dead.
Dylan's in, obviously.
Yeah, he's dead.
My man, Caitlin. Dead.
I go where my people need me.
Yeah. She's dead.
Okay, M.
She's dead.
What do you say?
She's definitely dead.
Yeah, I'm in.
No, she's not.
Mr. Hackett seemed pretty insistent we stay in the lodge.
He was just trying to freak us out, you know? Like one of Ryan's stupid ghost stories.
Why would he want to scare us?
Yeah. Like, why? He's got no reason to. Supportive.
I'm sure he's just looking out for us. No big deal.
Yeah.
All right, yeah.
No,
party.
I didn't mean...
High five. Touch my hand, Ryan.
I made a promise. You're dead.
I'm sorry. You made me promise.
Dude, he won't even know.
The group is getting bored of Ryan.
No, dude, we get it, all right? You don't want to disappoint Daddy.
Dismissive. Whatever, man. Someone's got to give a shit. Dismissive.
Whatever, man.
It's going to be fine, man. Trust me. It's going to be chill.
You're dead.
All right. Hacketeers. Party planning committee. Let's do this. Okay. First things first. Nick and Abby, you go get some firewood. Em and I will go to the stores for some supplies. And Dylan, you just, I don't know, figure out how to charge the phones or something. All right, let's do this.
Oh, and they all die. What's this? What's going on here? Oh, they're being watched. Buddy! This is Lance Henriksen. Are they like hillbillies? The Deliverance guy. Actually, Lance Henriksen looks a little bit like the Deliverance guy grown up. The kid. Why is he covered in blood? What? Yeah, because they look like the sort of people that want to party too. We're going to party. Hunting season. And that's where we leave this part of the episode. Before we get into any more of that. Paths. Let's see what we do with paths. Paths, camp. We've got loads to do. We won't. We will quit to main menu. Yes. And we can continue it from there another day. I don't know when. The game itself... It's sort of in between... I'm not sure. I'm just not sure of it yet. I'm just not sure. Oh shit, I'm gonna move that. Space Invaders in 2024. Like, hey, Mr. Alien, I'm like really uncomfortable with the proximity right now. So, socially distanced. I'm not sure about that. I'm not sure. The dialogue is so bad. I mean, I don't watch modern horror films. So, partly because the dialogue is so bad in modern horror films. But I will say that I like some of the characters, like two. But it's just a little bit cliched. And the whole here and now speak, the whole, like, the way people write scripts now, it's terrible. Because there's always, like, pointing out, you know, modern terms, modern terminology to keep it very current. It's almost like it's being forced. It's got its aesthetics in 80s, but it hasn't got the dialogue in 80s. So it's very odd. It's slightly off-putting, if I was to be completely honest. There was a game that they did. This company made a game, Until Dawn, if anyone played that. I've never had a PlayStation. So, I have had one, but they released it on PlayStation, 2015, I think. And this has been cast as its sort of sequel, unofficial sequel. Same company. I did see that game being played on the PS4, I think it was. Friend had it. And I did like the look of it. But again, that had some characters that were just really annoying. Just like really annoying. So give me 1 second. I'm going to be right back. It's going to go a bit dead for a while. I just got to get myself a quick vape. Vape. Take those things off now. I don't need the headphones on. Oh, they drag around my feet. Yeah, so I don't know who's... I say thanks, Old School Fool. Nice for you to drop in. It wasn't really a stream, a usual sort of stream. It was just to play that game, really. I don't know when I'll continue that game. I will continue it. I'm not ready to give up just yet. My initial idea was that there were werewolves in it, and I don't think there's werewolves in it now. I'm beginning to think it's a little bit more like... What was that series of films... I never liked Wrong Turn. Remember Wrong Turn? I mean, they made like 20 of those, and I never really got into them. I think I watched the first one, Wrong Turn, and I thought, it was again like a cliche. It was almost like we never went through the parody era, or we never went through the satire, or the attack of postmodern stuff by people like Wes Craven. It was almost like they just took it back to the 80s again. And that kind of horror, I've never liked. Even in the 80s, I never really watched it. Well, I think I may have. If I was like a 12-year-old and I watched Wrong Turn, I'd probably think it was the greatest horror movie ever. But because I've seen it all done and repackaged and then redone again and regurgitated again, it's like Wrong Turn, and that's what the ending of that reminds me of. Wrong Turn. I mean, I've recently, just to let you know, I recently watched Infinity Pool, which is David Cronenberg's son. Infinity Pool, and what was the other one? I've been watching them backwards. The first one I watched was Infinity Pool, which is his most current one. Brandon Cronenberg, which is his most current one. And then I watched Possessor, which I think is 2020. And I've got his first film. He's only made three. I've got his first one, which, what's the name of that? Antiviral is 2014. So I'm watching them out of order. I'm watching his newest first, and you know, and culminating with Antiviral, which is his oldest, from 2014, I think. Antiviral. I will say one thing is I thoroughly enjoyed both. I thoroughly enjoyed both of them. I can't say that they're sort of ones that I would rush out to see again. The Infinity Pool in particular, I think if it is going backwards, I'm expecting Antiviral to probably be his weakest. But going by what he's with the two that I watched, I would say that I'm looking forward to seeing Antiviral. I'm looking forward to see his progression if it is going backwards. But I really did like Infinity Pool and Possessor. Both visually very pleasing to the eye. Both visually got some good acting from a fairly unknown cast. Although Infinity Pool does have Skarsgård, what's his name, the guy who played the clown in It, Stellan Skarsgård's son, Alexander Skarsgård, who was fantastic in Infinity Pool, and also Mia Goth, who is quickly becoming my favourite modern day actress. Mia Goth, such an odd... Her performances are fantastic, though, and she's just... You watch her when she's on the screen. And Mia Goth was in Infinity Pool, and she was absolutely fantastic in that, like she is in a lot of things. I'm interested to watch Antiviral. As I said, I'm getting quite. I don't know why I haven't seen those sooner, because I'm a Cronenberg fan, early Cronenberg. But I was always a bit dubious about a son that, you know, I'd heard had sort of he's going down the father's path. And there are others around that have done that, like somebody like Max Landis, who. Probably less said about him the better, who even said that he would do an American Werewolf in London and make it better than his dad's version. What an idiot son. I was a bit dubious to hear it. He was going down his father, he was visiting his father's territory. But I will say one thing, while I haven't seen anything as mind-bendingly beautiful and horrific as Shivers or The Fly, I do see that his son does have something new to bring to that genre that was defined by, you know, the body horror by Cronenberg himself. So in a sort of minimalistic, beautiful way that he does, that Cronenberg used to do as well. So I'm quite excited by the fact that I watched those two, and I'm quite impressed by both of them. As I said, I don't think I could probably watch them again. But Cronenberg is somebody who I will always give time to. So, right. Well, I think that's it, really. It's 11 o'clock. I've been streaming for 3 hours. I don't know whether I'll do any more of this game, to be honest. I think I might over the next like couple of weeks, but I never know when I'm going to actually stream anymore. I'm down home on Monday to Wednesday, but I might do another part of this. I rarely stop playing a game. Like, I will persevere even if it's just total, like, I've played worse games than The Quarry to the end as well, because I refuse to not finish a game. It's like watching a movie. It's like I've never walked out of one film. I walked out of a cinema, one film that I walked out in the cinema, and that was The End of Violence. Wim Wenders bored the shit out of me. That movie did. Absolute Wim Wenders, one of the great directors. Wings of Desire. The End of Violence, terrible movie. I walked out of that, but I can't think of anything else I've walked out of. Like, so I I paid for my ticket. I'm going to sit there and I'm just going to watch the film. But yeah, there are one or two exceptions. And games are the same. Like I only paid £12 for the Quarry. I think I bought it on a sale, a Halloween sale in October or something. But thanks for watching. If you've got this far and you enjoyed the game, despite me ripping apart the dialogue or the characters, but I hope you will be as intrigued and interested to see their demise as I am, because there are definitely 80% of them that I wouldn't mind seeing beheaded, gutted, skewered, stabbed, shot, you name it. So maybe in the next episode we'll get to see a little bit some silly mistakes that some of those cocky for sure kids that they think that they're being cocky. I'm going to lead them down the path of death, because that's always fun. Oh, happy birthday, old school fool. How old are you? I'd say you're 55. 55. Am I right? 55. If you look at it from a distance, it looks like SS. I think you're about 5 years older than me. Maybe 6 years. I don't know. 55. 55. And I hope you get your floor in, mate. I hope you get your floor in at some point. Have I told you what floor I'm getting? That's all right, mate. That's all right. You know, trust me, it's nice to be able to catch up with you. I wasn't expecting anyone, to be honest. I was just going to stream it, just going to put something out on the channel live, because I want to keep the algorithms going, although it's probably just been me and you. It's probably just been me and you. I was saying earlier on in the stream that I do find it slightly disconcerting and slightly frustrating that with nearly 8,000 subscribers, no one accidentally watches the stream like when it's going out. But then you look at the stats on the channel, and it's something like 80% are over 65. So, you know, I'd be a fool to think they'd be interested in watching me play a game with a load of teenagers in a camp, you know, or playing a game of any kind. I'd be fooling myself thinking that there'll be more people, but the gaming streams, just YouTube gaming streams, I think everyone goes through it, but it is a bit disheartening when I just look at my figures and I think, of course, no one accidentally comes in and says anything. Although we did have somebody called Boo Marcel Boy. So, and I apologize, cause I didn't even look at the chat, cause I was playing the game for a good like 25, 30 minutes before I realized you guys were in the room. So, but yeah, the whole YouTube streaming thing is, you know, it's a bit frustrating sometimes, but, I enjoyed the game and I still will do the streams, even if it's just to two people or one person as it is at the moment. I think it's just me and you, old school fool. Literally, because I'm watching the stream as well. I've got it on mute because I was worried about my pink face. Well, I look up in case you announce the stream, so definitely I really appreciate that, mate. It was really good to catch up. I'm hoping that I'm away on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday to Thursday next week. I'm going out on the cut once everything has been removed from the saloon. I'm going out on the cut because I'm going to be using a power sander, and I want to survive off grid and see how long I can use my batteries and use my solar panel, because the sun's coming out now and I can charge my power bank, you see. So I will probably do a stream next Saturday. To keep that in your diary, mate, if you're about next Saturday, from the cut, probably an hour long. I think I did one an hour long before, but I'm going to do an hour long one. Hopefully, everything works out with the batteries and stuff. So I'm going to do an hour long with that. If not, I'm going to just run the engine. So there might be a little bit of engine noise coming from behind. But I've got to do a few tests for the boat. Before it's out of the water for 6 weeks at the end of May. So If you're about next Saturday, mate, then I'd be up, definitely up for that. I'm thinking of heading into Manchester with my camera tomorrow. The reason why I wouldn't do a Saturday night, because I'll be heading back probably. I'll get home to the boat about 9 o'clock at night, so I'll be a bit knackered because I'm going there through the day to take some pictures. Some street photography is what I'm doing tomorrow. Literally going to your channel and checking your communities. I won't be alone, I'm sure. Oh, mate, you're a legend. And I appreciate your support and stuff, as I've always said. So I am going to call it now because I've been on for 2 hours. 2 hours. 2 hours. And the game, who knows? If people want more, let me know in the comments if you've got this far and you're interested in seeing more of the Quarry. I'm probably going to play it. I can't say that. I'd say it's definitely weaning around a 6 or a 7 out of 10. But in terms of dialogue and in terms of the fact it's not set in the 80s, so I don't get all that references and stuff, it's a little bit, it's just a little bit samey. And now it's gone into Wrong Turn territory, which is, I'd rather have the werewolves. If it is going to go back to the werewolf thing, I'd rather have a werewolf. Than inbreds. I'm just tired of inbreds. John Borman did inbreds the best. I'll tell a lie, there was another one as well. I believe, trying to remember the director. Who directed The Warriors? He made a film called Southern Comfort. Powers Booth. Early 80s. That's good. But as I say, when I think of, like, you know, inbreds running around killing middle class white people, I'm just going to be thinking of Deliverance because that is the finest film. And then Southern Comfort. So I never bought into the Wrong Turn horror stuff. I never really liked that sort of stuff. Well, an hour's better than nought. Do miss the Saturdays. Sorry to pile that responsibility on you. See you tomorrow then. This was a special birthday stream for me. It was, mate. And happy birthday, mate. Happy birthday. 54. 54 years old. Have you had cake? Have you had your cake and have you eaten it? Did your wife get you a cake? Something. Made me laugh. Right. Okay. So that's it. That's the end of the stream. Thanks for watching. Appreciate that. Appreciate your support as always. And do bear with me because as soon as you'll be sick of me in July, if you watch, I'll be live streaming from the boat as I'm moving the boat. And I've done a little test and I'll be doing a bit of a test next week with the Insta 360. I'm hoping that that goes well, but there'll be plenty of boaty streams, probably not on Major Dolby's Cat though, coming up through the summer. And then the 4 weeks that I'm moving the boat south, once I'm established in my new location, it'll probably be back to normal. Every Saturday night, it'll be back to normal. Ooh, Southern Comfort, nice call. Yes. Oh, curry, a good curry. Everyone loves a bloody good curry. Good, that's a good wife, mate. You've got one of the better ones there, mate. You want to hold on to her. Ry Cooder, yes, Ry Cooder. Who directed Southern Comfort? I'm trying to remember his name. Same guy who did The Warriors. Oh, what's his name? Didn't he like produce 48 Hours as well, or did he direct 48 Hours? No, he did 48 Hours. He directed 48 Hours, The Warriors, and Southern Comfort, and I've forgotten his name. A great director. But yeah, Southern Comfort and Deliverance. I put them in the same ballpark. Deliverance a little bit more for the social political aspect, and then for the Southern Comfort for the action. Very tense. A lot of action. And Powers Booth. Who doesn't love Powers Booth? The late Powers Booth. Fantastic actor. One of my favourite characters in Deadwood as well. Walter Hill. Thank you. Thank you, Walter Hill. Warriors is great. 48 Hours is great. In fact, I think 48 Hours... Everyone always talks about Beverly Hills Cop, but I think 48 Hours is far superior to Beverly Hills Cop. Beverly Hills Cop's a fun comedy version, but 48 Hours is just the right amount of comedy and grittiness. But Walter Hill, fantastic. Is he still alive? Is Walter Hill still alive? But yeah, Rai Kuda soundtrack in Southern Comfort is a fantastic. Oh, that must be a really good soundtrack to get on vinyl. I got the Death Wish 2 vinyl soundtrack. I should look for that. I would have a look for that, actually. I was trying to find the Wish You Were Here soundtrack with the Emily Lloyd film, 1987, but it was never released in this country. A bloody soundtrack. I thought that might have been on vinyl. I'd love to get that on vinyl. Slightly different topic than Southern Comfort. Right. Thanks, Old School Fool. Happy birthday again, mate. Appreciate you dropping in and saying hi. And I won't leave it quite as long. Probably 8 days. Plan for next Saturday. Still alive, 84. I'd love for him to make movies still. Love for him to make a movie. Because he would shine a light on all the shite that's coming out of Hollywood that we has been for the last like few years. There's a couple of those directors that are around at that age, like Joe Dante, Walter Hill, John Landis. I put Landis in there as well. They must all be in their 80s now, late 70s, 80s, and they're all still pretty much capable of making something, just anything that would be better than what we have right now coming out of that place. But cool. Thanks again for your support, and happy birthday, mate. And I will catch you on the flip side, as the BFI flip side, a wonderful collection of obscure 70s movies is titled The Flip Side. And God bless Kim Newman.